I'm really so excited about our next guest. This young woman is currently just enlivening and ripping up Broadway in a way that few have done before her. She's the youngest winner ever of 3 Tony Awards. Her debut album, Way Back to Paradise, was named by the New York Times last year as the Adult Album of the Year. And it's a great pleasure to welcome in her Boston Pops debut, mezzo-soprano Audra McDonald.
Reach the park and I have been sort of on a crusade the past year or so, championing the new works of new composers, new Broadway composers who are just starting to come up in the field, composers that producers are just now starting to take a chance on. And now I want to take you on a little bit of a journey through some of these new composers. The first one I just did for you was Tom from Hello Again, which is a show by Michael John Lacusa, which was done at Lincoln Center. And the next two songs I'm going to do for you are from two other composers. One is Adam Gettle, who happens to be the grandson of Richard Rodgers. And that song is called Baby Moon. And the other one is called Lullaby, which was written by another fabulous composer named Ricky Ian Gordon. So this is Baby Moon.
Inside of me, I feel you like a warm ball of light waiting for dawn. While we are here and we have this connection, this kind of affection, before you are gone. Need to mention, and I hope that it isn't going to come as a blow. The last thing I want is to shock or upset you. I haven't even met you, but you've got to know. And elsewhere likewise love is stirred, elsewhere the speechless song is heard, wherever children sleep awake, souls are lifted.
Thank you.
please help me welcome back Audra McDonald.
When you're in love and you are wondering if he really is the one, there's an ancient sign sure to tell you if your search is over and done. Catch a bee, and if he don't sting you, you're in hot spell that's just begun. It's a guarantee. On me, don't wake up, can't believe what just passed. He's mine for the taking, I'm so happy at last. Maybe our dreams, but he seems sweet, golden as a crown. Asleep and be done to me. I walks with my feet off the ground when my one true love has
Sleep and Be is a great old tune. Many of you probably know it, written by Harold Arlen with lyrics by Truman Capote himself. And Arlen means a lot to me because he meant a lot to another singer who is my goddess, Judy Garland. And I'd like to do my own sort of mini tribute to Harold Arlen and Judy Garland by singing The Man That Got Away. And there's no way that I could sing it quite like Judy Garland did in the big, incredibly grand style. So this is my own little quiet tribute to Judy Garland. The night is bitter. Stars have lost their glitter. The winds grow colder. Suddenly you're older. And all because of the man that got away. Good riddance, goodbye. Every trick of his, you're on to. But fools will be fools. And where's he gone to? The road gets rougher. Lonelier and tougher. Hope you burn up. Tomorrow he might turn up. There's just no let up. The live long night and day. Ever since this world began, looking for the man that got traits of any value but his smile. I met a man who had no year, no claim to fame, who was content to let life pass him for a while. And I was sure that all I ever wanted was a life like the movie stars led. And he kissed me right here. And
he said, I'll give you stars in the moon and a soul to guide you and a promise I'll never go. I'll give you hope to bring out all the life inside you and the strength that'll help you grow. I'll give you truth and a future that's 20 times better than any Hollywood plot. And I thought, you know, I'd rather have a yacht. I met a man who lived his life out on the road, who left a wife and kids in Portland on a whim. I met a man whose fire and passion always showed, who asked if I could spare a week to ride with him. But I was sure that all I ever wanted was a life that was scripted and planned. Said, but you don't understand. I'll give you stars in the moon and the open highway and a river beneath your feet. I'll give you days full of dreams if you travel my way and a summer you can't repeat. I'll give you nights full of passion and days of adventure, no strings, just one summer rain. And I thought, you know, I'd rather have champagne. I met a man who had a fortune in the bank, who had retired at age 30, set for life. I met a man and didn't know which stars to thank, and then he asked one day if I would be his wife. And I looked up, and all I could think of was the life I had dreamed I would live. I said to him, what will you give? I'll give you cars and a townhouse in Turtle Bay and the fur and the diamond ring. And we'll get married in Spain on my yacht today and we'll honeymoon in Beijing. And you'll meet stars at the parties I throw in my villas in Nice and Paris in June. And I thought, okay. And I took a breath. And I got my yacht, and the years went by, and it never changed, and it never grew, and I never dreamed. And I woke one day, and I looked around, and I thought, my God, I'll never have the moon.
Roosting in the tree, pick up and go. For a list of the pieces performed on tonight's Evening at Pops concert and more, visit PBS online at www.pbs.org. Evening at Pops was underwritten by a grant from the Fidelity Foundation. For 33 years, the philanthropy of Fidelity Investments, where 12 million investors put their trust.
Fulfillment comes from knowing you've done your best, but we believe it's possible to do more. Because the most fulfilling aspect of charitable giving is its lasting benefit for others. The Charitable Gift Fund, bringing more to giving. Proud to support public television.
KCET presents an Upstairs Downstairs for a New Generation. It's the acclaimed Berkeley Square, and it continues tomorrow night at 9. Touching Evil on Mystery is next on KCET. There's infinitely more mystery on KCET as the final two parts of Touching Evil are presented back-to-back with descriptive video next on KCET.
Hello, I'm Val Zavala, and I'd like to welcome Warren Olney to the KCET family.
Thank you very much. Val and I will be the new co-hosts of Life and Times Tonight.
So for in-depth reports, interviews, and features covering what's happening in Southern California,
join us every weeknight right here on KCET.
Warren Olney and Val Zavala on Life and Times Tonight, weeknights at 7 on KCET.
When your life turns dull, colorless, uninviting, get back to nature. Fresh air.
The virtual spider, their real hand would touch this real spider, and they would have the illusion of physically touching the virtual spider. This blurred the distinction between real and virtual, and we think promoted successful therapy.
I'm a little scared of spiders. I mean,
I was curious, so I decided to try it for myself.
It looks good. Looks like a room.
Every time you move your hand.
Oh, there's my hand, yeah.
The cyber hand moves.
Once I got used to the virtual kitchen, I went looking for a spider.
Let's see you try to touch it.
Where's my...
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. He's warmer and furrier than I ever anticipated a spider to be. Now, how does this help people who have a deathly fear of spiders? I know I felt like dropping this spider as soon as I touched it.
By approaching the thing that they fear, gradually their anxiety goes away.
It's amazing. It's amazing how real it feels.
It was hard enough for me to do it. For Sheila, who had lived with her phobia for 30 years, it was nearly impossible. How'd she do it? With weeks and weeks of steady progress, eventually she was able to conquer her fear.
Each time I would just approach the spider and deal with it, handle it, and I would control it. I would put it into cupboards. I would smash it. And I found that I was finally able to do that with real spiders, too. The feeling was almost like relief.
I think clearly where we are in using virtual reality for the treatment of phobias is just at the very beginning, that it's probably a lot more likely that people will be able to do their own desktop virtual reality.
Hunter Hoffman believes this treatment can help...